friends, welcome to today's Fuel for Our Spiritual Fire. In this scripture where the Pharisees are testing Jesus, the thing that really stood out to me when I was reading that today was that they started with flattery, and I thought, isn't that just like the devil? He always waits till we're feeling really good about ourselves, and then he brings the lie. So he has absolutely no power over us except for that which we agree with him. So he might send a lie to us saying, oh, you just sinned because da 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 da. Well, the scriptures say that the accuser of the brethren is the devil. We also know that he is the father of lies. So he takes something we did or he plants a thought, and we might say, oh man, I'm so bad. I can't believe I was thinking of doing that again. I guess I'm not really a loving Christian or a holy saint or whatever. I guess I'm not really being faithful to God. But see, he's accusing us and he's planting that thought. So what do? He waited till we were feeling good about ourselves and then he sneaks it in and he's hoping that we'll just agree with him. Because as soon as we agree with him, our faith is weakened, our confidence in Christ is weakened, and we begin to have a guilty complex that makes us want to run away from God and not spend time with him. We feel discouraged. So what do? When the enemy comes and plants a lie in our minds and accuses us, makes us feel bad about something we did or challenges us, you know, first we're feeling great, then all of a sudden he points out a misstep we made. Here's how we respond. Instead of running away from the lie or feeling guilty, we need to attack the lie with truth. Whenever these thoughts that undermine our confidence come, that's the time to speak the word of God about ourselves. I thank God that he has made me faithful. The Spirit of God dwells in me. His will is for me to be holy, and his grace is sufficient for me. So I know that by God's grace, I will be holy. I know that by his grace, I'm the mother he's called me to be to my children, or I'm the housekeeper that he's called me to be. You know, God gives us grace, for all the grace we need for life and godliness. So whenever we feel attacked that we're not doing things right or good enough or holy enough, all we need to do is remember what the scriptures say about us, because this is the truth that will stand. We renew our mind, we encourage ourselves by speaking those things, and the enemy's desire to weaken us and destroy our resolve and our confidence all of a sudden is turned into fuel for our spiritual fire, driving us closer to God with great strength and encouragement. So I hope this word fuels your spiritual fire today, and I want to send a special shout out to all of Nikki's friends. Hey, Nikki's friends, I am so happy you joined me. I've been having so much fun with the Nikki videos and the Do It on the Dime videos, and that other girl, the clutterbug girl. Oh my goodness, I'm learning so much. I haven't hardly been able to sleep for the past 2 weeks because I've been getting so much stuff organized in my house. It's just like thrilling. I'm so inspired. Well, anyhow, I hope this has brought you some inspiration too, and thank you so much for being a part of my YouTube family. Bye-bye.